Thorsten says, I have the following problem and hope to find a solution or some ideas. In our company, we use Office 365, mainly Outlook and Teams. Now we have a new project with a new customer in which more than 30 colleagues will work. One requirement from the customer is that all people on the project have to work in the Office 365 of the customer, so in the customer's tenant. Pretty standard. Our main problem is that everybody now has now two Office 365 accounts, and so we have two calendars that are independent. Now my question, do you have a solution idea for how we sync both Office 365 accounts, mainly the calendars? I am an account user at company.de, so one, and one from usercompany.com. I would like to sync all appointments from one to two just with the information that there is an appointment, and from one with more details. I tried it with ICS files, but only I can see them locally and nobody nor in Teams calendar. I hope you understand my problem and eventually you have ideas how to solve it. Probably the most common question that we field is a different flavor of the sharing calendars problem.
Yeah, we have it all the time because we're dealing with often so many clients and partners and Microsoft. And so it can be challenging on the PC, but mobile is your friend.
Well, I mean,
I find
most people aren't going to be on their mobile all the time, especially with the things that pinging.
That's
out.
Right. Yeah, yeah.
I live in this world every single day, and that was my biggest challenge. So the only thing that I have found that consistently syncs and works is I actually use Calendar Bridge. You can use Calendly too as well. But if you set that up, it connects them. When it connects them, it actually syncs them across both of them. So if you look in any of my clients that I have to be in theirs, they see every meeting that's booked from every other client, but it doesn't show the information, but it shows it saying that I'm blocked so they can't schedule a meeting. So in each, every one of them, they all know when I'm available every single day because they're synced, but you have to use that third party tool. There's nothing native out of the box that works.
The only other thing for visibility is that you can share your calendar with each of your profiles. Then it gives you a visibility, but it doesn't do what you're talking about and blocking out the space.
Yeah. You don't have that true sync. Yeah.
Right. Yeah. I just had that problem today where somebody said, hey, are you available? It looks like you're open, and they scheduled the meeting. I'm like, no, actually I'm double booked already. And so no, I won't be able to make it. And it was because I could see that because I've shared between my profiles. And the other thing I'll say that Microsoft, of course, has been harassed by the MVPs in the world. All of us together in a unified voice on this problem.
Yes.
And on multi-tenant and being able to do more across within the team's view of the world. And things are getting better there. But this calendaring problem and with Outlook.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
I don't know that there's anything on the horizon other than third party.
Yeah, the only way I do it is I have the mini accounts on my mobile phone, and then I have that open. I have my calendaring for the day. I have it open on my phone. It's sort of beside me, plugged into power, and I keep an eye out on so that if I'm talking to people, I can work with it because with the multiple accounts added in that way. And I mean, if you can add in multiple accounts to your Outlook. And you can do it that way, and you're able to, because a lot of organizations don't allow it. If you can add that account as well to your Outlook, you can then choose both calendars and have them so that you can put them in overlay. You can see them, but the thing is, it's not stopping people from booking the same time. So that's the difference, you know, that piece, you know, where you're talking about, Stacey, where they can see that it's actually blocked out. Unless you've got a, you know, rule or automation that you can say that anything you get in your calendar, they can't afford to one or the other. But the potential downside of that is some of the confidentiality of having things going into other people, like forwarding it and having it across the two. So I've done it that way as well, the sync side of things.
Unfortunately, it brings that data over. You can't hide it. So like I have the multiple profiles in my Outlook and then I have them all overlay. So I used to literally take screenshots and send it to my partners each week, right?
Yeah.
But still, if they didn't look at it, they could still go schedule something when I already had something. So when I got calendar, I now I'm just like, here's a link, go book a meeting. And I don't have to go look on four different calendars or anything, right?
Yep.
And every one of them, they go into their system and they can see when I'm available. And I've been in heaven ever since. What I found is the pricing is very different. Calendar Bridge, all of them are very similar in pricing, especially for large organizations. So it's, I mean, if it's, you know, for this project for 30 people, and if it's only a short period of time, maybe try it out, see what you think.
Yeah. So. It's good to know. I wasn't aware of Calendar Bridge. So that's, I learned something. Appreciate that.
No problem. I will never go back now. Oh my.
Yeah, I know. It's been a real challenge. The amount of times I've been just working and then totally missed something else because I'm on another laptop or with another client or working out of, and I've gone, oh, oops, sorry.
Yep.
So yeah, it is absolutely a challenge.
I call it my game changer.
Cool. I'll get on that one. Thank you.